Hey guys, this video is going to be a little different from my usual ones. Instead of a straight build montage, this project is using a bunch of pre-purchased parts that I'm kind of cobbling together, and I thought it would need some explanation. And please bear with me, this is my first time doing voiceover video, so I'm still figuring it all out. So you may have seen last year, I worked on my tiny little lathe build, which was pretty cool, but the problem is I don't really use it. I think I've used it twice in the last year since making it, so it's not really useful in my shop. Especially since I got my tag lathe, I don't really need one with less features than that, so I thought I would tear it down and make something fun and useful with. Well, maybe useful. We'll see. Anyway, I decided to make what I'm calling the micro mill press, which will hopefully be a small precision mill drill press hybrid. And the cool thing about this build is I'm going to recycle a lot of parts and pieces that I've had laying around, some even for years, and this will make it a fairly inexpensive build for me, which is always nice. For starters, I had these steel plates cut out on the plasma table and welded together at work. These are massively overkill for this project, but I like overkill. I do need to make an adapter piece for the shaft to stepper motor connection, so let's get going on that. Okay, so now that that's done, I've hopped over to the Nomad to start milling all the counterbores for the cross slide. I had these parts water jet cut in 3/8 inch aluminum to save me some mill time. This piece is the bottom half, which basically will tie in all four linear bearings on the lead screw carriage. The second piece will thread into the top of this, where the actual cross slide will sit. These screws were put in loosely at first and then tightened later, after I'd run it up and down the rails a bunch, just to give it some natural alignment. I took the semi-aligned state to line up and mark where the stepper bracket would go, so that I could drill and tap those. And then onto the top half, which is just like the bottom half, but with less holes. With that done, I can work on mounting the cross slide. I'm using a Tag Tools compound slide for this, which is an accessory for their micro lathe. It's a little smaller than I would like, but it is a complete slide with an indicated handle and zero backlash, and I own it already. I figure I can always upgrade it later if I need to. The only modification I need to make is to drill and tap some holes so it can be threaded onto the top plate. In hindsight, this isn't the best way to attach it, as it'll make aligning the slide difficult later on, but I'll figure something out. And I did this off camera because I totally forgot to record. That's all the pieces for the first part of this build, so time to put it all together. This will still be in a semi-loose state so that I can align everything once the rest of it is finished. So I hope my narration wasn't too cringeworthy for you and didn't put you to sleep. Like I said, this is my first attempt, so hopefully it'll only get better from here. Thanks for watching, and if you want to see more stuff like this, please like and subscribe, and let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. We'll see you next time.